doesn't have a car or who's stuck at the office, maybe a manager, you know, they're not able to get out as much. Also, other transportation, the medical transportation, we get calls from Transcom, which is, you know, insurance broker, or Fresenius Health Partners, and connect us with the client who is maybe at a nursing home, but needs a transportation, but not emergency. So, you know, they'll tell us the kind of vehicle that they need, you know, what kind of driver they need, and sometimes they'll schedule it maybe for the whole week. Sometimes they may schedule it just for maybe a Friday or Tuesday, whatever the case is, and we'll send them. Try to create this culture of, you know, just positivity and friendliness. And also us being, you're able to reach us through the phone, so you're able to contact somebody rather than, you know, through an app. So somebody who's, you know, in their 60s or 70s may not know how to, you know, navigate through an app, and they want to call in and speak to, you know, a real voice. And that is what we provide.
So we started the business with a Yelp ad and a free trial on GoDaddy website. And now we're doing pretty good in sales, and most of our sales come from the non-emergency medical. With reaching into delivery service, we're reaching new market students. We are having an app developed at this time. We also have a functional website within delivery, medical, and regular transportation. We're really focused on growth right now, but at the same time, we're taking baby steps at certain times, because we're making sure we're in the right place and doing the right things, particularly in the way of making sure we're covered and also making sure that we're not growing too quickly. We started this idea in this business with the idea that we could solve Robinson County's transportation problem and provide this service and solve and really fill the gap. So we hope to provide that and be able to reach to the community, and we need your help to do that. Really, awareness and exposure is a huge thing for us, for small business, especially for the delivery service. As I said before, most of our business comes from non-emergency medical, but again, reaching out to the students.
And trying to figure out how to tap into that market, into the students and into the, you know, just the local crowd, which we haven't figured that out yet.
Right. Thank you, guys.
You're very sweet.